White's next move is to put his king on that crucial white square right here. That really hurt what I was trying to do. Now I can't move this pawn up. There's no way in heck that I'm going to be able to get all the way around, and you know, I'd have to go way over here in order to even attack this f-pawn, which he could easily defend anyway. So that pretty much forced my king to go over to this side of the board here, which I do. Now I'm at this point making a move towards his knight. If I can just force it off of that A4 square, no matter where he moves, it's going to be captured. So the only possible move he would really have would be to move his B-pawn up here to B3 to defend the knight, and then he can move his knight back to that square that the B-pawn was on. And that would be the only way he could get it out. Of course, that's a useless square for him to be on. He's still close to the back corner of the board, and he would have to come back here to D1 and then hook around, and he would have to waste a lot of moves just to free up that knight. So that knight has actually been really bad for him all game, and particularly in the end game here. Now he moves his king off of that crucial square. I'm not sure why he did that. I don't really care. My idea here is to now get these doubled up pawns going and free up the back ranks here so I can maybe try to do something with my bishop. He's just moving his king back and forth. He really doesn't have too many moves here, so he doesn't have a lot of moves. He's just hoping I make a mistake. And now we're kind of playing a cat and mouse game with our kings. I am making some strategic moves and developing my pieces slowly but surely, but I'm also being very tentative along the way. So you see he moves his king back. Now I've cut him off here. Because he couldn't really move any other pieces there, he couldn't even move this f-pawn up because it would have trapped him in that spot if I wanted him to be there. So that may not have been a bad thing because my moves were also very limited there too, because I had to stay on that E6 square to defend this E5 pawn. So there was some tension going on there, but he decided to retreat because he's going to make a run back towards this side of the board, which he's now doing. And I proceed with my plan now to try to come around the flanks and cut him off, and I'm still wanting to really get rid of this f-pawn. He scoots over, essentially relinquishes that pawn to me, but you'll see how quickly that plan goes awry. All I have to do is move back here to e1, and now he's protecting the pawn again. Okay, now he's in trouble because now I have the ability to do a little pawn storm here, and I'm basically just rushing his position. And he's forced to make the exchange. I take it back. That hurt him. He moves up, but I still have pawns that I can threaten him with. So now he's in check. Now he still has to protect his f-pawn. Move my other pawns up. Now look at how the dynamics changed here. Granted, his knight still can't move anywhere or it'll be captured, but he has to play these three pawns here very special way in order to not come out behind. He moves his king. He doesn't want to move those pawns yet. He doesn't really have much of a choice of what he's going to do with those pawns. And now I realize I'm not going to get this f-pawn. And you look at this little setup. The e-file, he's blocked from getting on the e-file. And actually, he's blocked from really getting out in either of these files out into the open because all of these squares right here are threatened by my pawns. So he really has no moves. He's trapped there. And he has no other pieces that can come and back him up. That knight is stuck. So this f-pawn, even though it looks like it's abandoned, because I had him set up strategically, I can now move my king back over here and get rid of his knight. He moves up, but that's the only square he can go to. I have to kind of dance around the knight's path of moves here. So he moves his a-pawn. That doesn't do anything. Now he's forced to move his knight or protect it. And he defends it here with the B pawn, but as you can see, that's forcing an exchange here by me, or at least the threat of the exchange. Now you'll see I'm just really wanting him to take my bishop. I don't want him to go back here to B2 because I know that I'm up in material, even though it's just a mere pawn. And if I can get rid of that knight, because I'm not going to be able to take it because he's defending it, the only way is to force that exchange. So I'm hoping beyond hope he takes it. He does. Probably his best move, because again, even if he moved it back here, it wasn't going to do much for him on that B2 square. So he got an even exchange there. That's pretty much all he could do. I capture it back. He goes ahead and takes the pawn. I capture that back. So now you can see I'm still up 4 pawns to 3. His king is still pretty much trapped because, as you can see right here, I still have those same squares occupied. Those are very crucial squares for me.